Welcome back to Indie Now. Today is National Artists as an Outlaw Day, which is apparently a real holiday.
Yes, that's right.
And we have one of the best, and we must say coolest, artists with us today. Gary G is teaching us a few quick drawing and sketching techniques.
Gary, what's up, Brian?
What's happening, Jilly?
Well, it's so great to have you back here. How have you been?
Man, I've been pretty good, so I guess I'm going to get started here.
Yeah, let's get into it.
While we're talking, who's model first?
I think Jillian should
let's
be.
Take Jillian. Okay. So ask me some questions, Ryan.
You're drawing me right now?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Have you ever been drawn before?
I can't say I have.
Gary, so it's National Artist as an Outlaw Day.
Yes.
And when we heard about this national holiday, which is a real thing, we're like, we got to get Gary G back on the show. Because you love pushing the boundaries of your creativity. You love breaking some rules every now and then when it comes to art. Tell us about what it means to be an outlaw to you.
Man, it's pretty good. It feels like, you know, we're in outlaw country. What's this, Dillinger? We're in Dillinger town.
Oh, that's right.
So it feels pretty good. You know, I guess I was breaking rules when I came and hung out with y'all last time.
Oh, yeah.
Up there on James Rookham Riley's tomb.
Yep.
It's just fun, man. Like, I guess like me now, we're drawing with Sharpie, which is kind of deviant.
Yeah.
And I always liked it as a kid, like drawing with ink pens.
Yeah.
Because I wasn't supposed to. So I think, it's fun breaking rules successfully.
Yeah.
You know, you got to know the rules sometimes in order to break them in art.
Yeah.
And that's what we feel has been pretty cool. And so now we have this quick little character of Jillian.
I know.
You're
doing great.
I know. I'm looking at this like, wow.
It's looking amazing. We're going to do
a little bit
of a
reveal. And she is going to start painting her own.
Oh, wow. Look at that.
Look at that profile.
Can we get a tight shot right here? Right here? Where are we going?
Oh,
right here after
look at that.
Yeah. There we go.
I'm very flattered. Thank you, Gary.
It's looking good.
Kind of light.
We're getting
into that. That is cool. Yeah.
Take that.
I mean, he just whipped that up in like 2 seconds.
Thank you. That one.
So I'm painting this.
Yeah.
And then
profile.
We have a few odd colors. Okay. We're going to do like some funky abstracts today.
Ooh,
I like that.
So the colors are whatever you choose.
Okay.
Whatever you choose.
So you want me just to like get right
just
into
get
it?
Just get in. So what I will tell you is the brushes there, those chisel brushes are pretty good for cutting in the angles.
Okay.
I was supposed to put you some water up here too. I have some.
Oh, you know, that's all right.
Get you some water just in case.
Gotta get some water.
I'm gonna start on the shirt just because I see you have orange here and I'm wearing an orange shirt, so.
Oh yeah, you gotta get that.
Orange.
Yeah.
We kinda coordinated color wise today. Just a little bit. Ryan has the bright blue blazer.
You know, gotta keep it real.
Yeah.
We all kinda are in the same palette a little bit.
Yeah. I should have wore a brighter blue.
That's
and I
would
have asked y'all, but hey, we're on the same memo
we
without
are.
A memo.
Gary, how did you even get into this in the first place? Like, how did you know that you had this talent?
Well, I think my mom knew more than me, but there are a lot of relatives in my family that can actually draw. They're all pretty good artists. But I was the one who used to, like, draw on everything that came in the house.
Yeah.
So, like, when my grandmother would get a letter or they go to the grocery store, we had the old paper sacks.
Yeah.
I would just draw on everything. So I guess after a while, they got tired of me drawing on everything. And they decided to get me some stuff to be, like, proficient with art with.
That's cool.
So my mom got me, like, a real art kit when I was in, like, the sixth grade.
Nice.
Yeah.
And kind of never looked back after that. But I was the kid, like, so when we're on Breaking the Rules, when I was supposed to be doing schoolwork, I would generally be drawing teachers or kids in the class making fun of them.
Okay. He was that kid again.
You were that kid.
Yes,
so I was that kid. and then a couple of them was like, hey, you need to go pursue your art. And then, you know, I would do little deviant stuff growing up. But I ended up going back to Ivy Tech in my 30s.
Yeah.
And actually got like a couple of degrees in art. So, which my mom was telling me when I was a kid is what I needed to do.
I love that.
So
man.
It kind of like helped solidify what I think I'm supposed to be doing.
Yeah, it's cool to hear that you have that support from family, too, to really foster that gift. Gary, you got some exhibits coming up. Tell people about the two art exhibitions that you have coming up next month.
So next month, I will be in Meet the Artists with the 18 Collective. So that's all of us that did the Black Lives Matter mural a couple of years ago on Indiana Avenue.
Yeah.
And then we will also be at Saks Fifth Avenue next month. And as well, we have another location that I forgot. We'll be at the East 38th Street branch as well as part of Meet the Artist.
Okay.
So the collective will be pretty busy next month. It's a good way for people to come out, meet some artists, even start a collection or just chit-chat in general.
I love it, man.
And a lot of people in the new year, they're looking for different things they could try, outlets, hobbies. You know, even if you don't feel like you're a natural artist, there's a lot of people who want to get started.
Yeah.
So what would you recommend for somebody watching right now, maybe for themselves, maybe for their kids even?
I tell people that if you can write your name, you can draw.
Hmm.
I teach a few art classes, so at Ivy Tech, but I'm also working with Arts for Learning, so some of your kids may see me.
All right.
Especially if they're in the second grade this year. I got a lot of second grades.
That's awesome.
But, yeah, so a lot of times drawing and art is pretty much just shapes. And if you can create the shapes, you can pretty much do whatever you want with the shapes.
I love
and it. And keep in mind, do not compare yourself to another artist. Compare yourself to you. Hmm. You are your...
Look at
Come
that.
On. You got the glasses and the hair and everything, Gary
okay,
G.
Okay, well, that's amazing.
Oh, man.
Yeah, next one, I'm not going to draw me. I'm going to draw a cool cameraman.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, you
got to
get Eric.
Yeah,
we're
going
to check in at the end of the show.
Because every time I've been here, Eric's hooked me up.
Oh, Eric's, we Eric's love legit. Eric. We He's love Eric. Best. This is amazing.
Well, we're going to let you keep drawing Eric, and we're going to let you do your thing. And at the end of the show, we'll show a little bit more. But, Gary, you're amazing. Let's remind people where they can find you.
You can find me on Instagram pretty much every day at Original Gary G, or on my website, Art by Gary G, which I'll probably update sometime this week.
All right. Okay, perfect. Yeah.